Francis turbine tutorial question number 2. A backward Francis turbine work at head of 45 meters. Runner's diameter at inlet and outlet is 90 centimeters and 60 centimeters respectively. The runner's width is 12 centimeters at inlet and outlet. Blade angle at outlet is 15 degrees. Velocity of flow is constant at 3.5 meters per second and there is no whirl at outlet. If hydraulic efficiency is 90%, determine the turbine speed in RPM, the flow rate, the guide vane angle, the inlet blade angle, and the power generated from turbine. To answer this question, first you need to draw your velocity triangle. And this is the velocity triangle at the inlet, and this is the velocity triangle at the outlet. From the question, we know that V2 is equal to 0, then the velocity triangle will become like this. From the question, we know that the width of blade for inlet and outlet is equal. It is 0.12 meters. The diameter at inlet is 0.9 meter and diameter at outlet is 0.6 meter. The velocity of flow is also constant. It is equal to 3.5 meter per second. Constant here means the value of VF1 is equal to VF2. Then we could use VF only in the calculation without any subscript of 1 and 2. The V2 is equal to 0 and the hydraulic efficiency is equal to 90%. Now we are calculating the turbine speed in RPM. You already know that the only equation that have RPM is U equal pi dN over 60. We rearrange this equation and we take the parameter at point number 2, we could say that n equals 60 U2 over pi D2. To get the value of n here, we need to determine the value of U2. From the velocity triangle here at the outlet here, we could calculate the value of beta 2 here by using the VF2 over U2. However, the value of beta 2 here is already known. It is 15 degrees. So we could rearrange this equation becomes U2 equal VF2 over tangent beta 2. And we substitute all the value, we could get U2 is equal 13.06 meter per second. We substitute the value of U2 in the equation, we could get the RPM is 416 RPM. Now we are calculating the flow rate. The equation that have flow rate is VF equal Q over K pi dB. In this question, we don't have any information about the thickness of the blade. So we could assume that the value of K here is 100%. Or it is equal to 1. We substitute all the value. In this equation, we could get the flow rate here is equal to 0.792 meter cube per second. Next, we are calculating the guide vane angle. Here, the guide vane angle is the angle at V1 here because the flow angle for V1 is determined or shaped by the guide vane. So this location or this angle is known as the guide vane angle. From this velocity triangle, we could say that tangent theta is equal to VF1 over V1. VF1 is already calculated. So we need the value of V1 to fulfill in this equation to get the value of theta. From the question, we know that the hydraulic efficiency is 90% or 0.9, and this is the equation of the hydraulic efficiency. Because of V2 here is equal to 0, we could simplify the equation for hydraulic efficiency is equal to V1 U1 over GH. Then we could rearrange the equation to calculate V1 is 0.9 GH over U1. We could calculate the value of U1 by using this equation, and we get 19.6 meter per second. Then we could calculate the V1 by using this equation, and we get 20.27 meter per second. Finally, we substitute all the value in this equation, we could get the value of theta here is equal to 9.8 degree. Next, we are calculating the inlet blade angle. The inlet blade angle is located here at beta 1. And from the velocity triangle, we could calculate beta 1 with VF1 over V1 minus U1. We substitute all the value that we have here. We could get beta 1 is equal 79.6 degree. And finally, we need to calculate the power generated from the turbine. The general equation for power is rho GQH. But in this question, we need to calculate power generated by the turbine. So we need to use the head here is the Euler head. The Euler head can be calculated by using this equation, which is 1 over G V1 U1. We substitute all the value in the equation, we could get power generated from turbine is 314.67 kilowatt.